Asbestos is a fibrous mineral, and when you disturb it, these fibers get airborne. So when you're talking about asbestos diseases, the exposure is generally through inhalation of airborne fibers, which means you're looking at some form of lung disease. One of the earliest forms of the lung disease that we saw was something called asbestosis, which was a scarring of the lungs. This physically makes it difficult to breathe. And that happened early on in most cases because of the extremely high asbestos exposures. Most of these people died before cancer even developed. So now what we see are these longer latency diseases, regular lung cancer, which is of the lung tissue itself, and another cancer called mesothelioma, which is a cancer of the lining of the lungs and the lining of the internal organs. And they get embedded in these other places and can cause these long-term cancers, which might take 30 or 40 or 45 years to manifest. So a young worker who is exposed in his or her 20s today, they'll be retired or close to retirement in their 60s, you know, looking forward to looking after their grandchildren. And then this will strike them as a consequence of what they were exposed to early on. At some point, a threshold will be reached that's a trigger. And unfortunately, as with a lot of cancers, we don't know where that trigger is with individuals.